Google has announced that Data Studio is now Looker Studio. So what is Looker Studio? Has anything changed? And is there anything we need to do to access our Google Data Studio reports and dashboards we've already created? I'm going to answer these questions and more in this video. Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. I'm not sure about you, but I was a bit surprised by Google's decision to change the name of Data Studio to Looker Studio. It reminds me of when Google changed their logo from this to this. Anyway, let's jump in and look at what's changed in Google Data Studio. Okay, so back in 2019, Alphabet, Google's parent company, announced that they were acquiring a company called Looker. Looker was and is a business intelligence platform with machine learning, reporting, data visualization, and more. In their announcement, Google said that the acquisition would allow enterprises to leverage the power of analytics, machine learning, and AI. Since the acquisition was finalized in 2020, Google has continued to offer the solutions provided by Looker, and they've been working to integrate Looker into their own platforms. This is the next step. As part of this, Google has renamed Google Data Studio to Looker Studio. In their blog post announcing the name change, Google said that they're unifying our business intelligence product family under the Looker umbrella. Google has also said that Looker Studio will continue to be improved, so we're likely to see new BI, business intelligence features, added to Looker Studio in the future. So overall, Google Data Studio is now called Looker Studio. Let's head to Looker Studio to take a look. If you've been using Google Data Studio, then Looker Studio will look familiar. It's really just Data Studio rebranded as Looker Studio. We can see a new logo on the top and the new name. And the URL is still actually datastudio.google.com. The home section is the same. And let's open a report to see if anything has changed there. Again, it looks the same as Data Studio, just with the new logo and name. Okay, so let's click Edit and take a bit more of a look. Again, it all looks the same. If you haven't opened Data Studio for a few weeks, then the data panel on the right is now resizable. This was tweaked at the start of September, so that's nice to see. It felt a bit squished when the second column was added to the interface. So everything we had in Data Studio is still available in Looker Studio. Currently, Looker Studio is simply a rebranded version of Google Data Studio. As we saw, the URL for Looker Studio is still datastudio.google.com, but some things are changing. Google has also announced Looker Studio Pro, which is a paid version of Looker Studio. The Pro version is designed for enterprise customers and includes features around integrating Looker Studio with their security and management requirements. This is basically to ensure that the right people have access to the right data. We're talking about things like having an SLA, a service level agreement, and management of data sharing, things like that. Now, you might also be wondering, what's the difference between Looker Studio and Looker? Looker is Google's enterprise platform for business intelligence. It lets organizations connect existing data sources, like BigQuery, to run SQL-type queries. Again, it's an enterprise-level platform. If you'd like to learn more about Looker, I've included some links in the description below this video. And as we've seen, Data Studio has been replaced by Looker Studio. This is where you can connect data sources to create dashboards and reports using a range of visualization options. Plus, you can also combine data and create custom metrics and dimensions. And I want to highlight that even though there is a pro version, this doesn't mean that you need to pay to use Looker Studio. We can still use the free version, just like we could with Data Studio. So if you've been using Data Studio, there's nothing special you need to do. You can still head to datastudio.google.com and access all of your existing reports and create new ones. And if you're new to Data Studio, I mean Looker Studio, then check out my existing tutorials. I will be updating these to reflect the new name, but you can still follow all the same steps to create your own dashboards and reports. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel for more updates. I'll see you in the next video.